Petey and Jared Guillory coming to you live from the tractor. This last weekend, I got booked to MC a wedding. Real fancy, high society type wedding. Real fancy. Well, you could tell the girl's parents was real uppity, but the boys not so much. But anyway, I'm at the wedding. And guys, never, ever, ever, never, 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 ever, 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 never, never let a drunk person get on a microphone at a special event if you don't know what they're going to say. Just don't let it happen. I was on the podium talking about weddings or new beginnings at the podium side, and this little Flavor Flav looking dude goes up to the bandstand across the room and grabs the band microphone and does, excuse me. The funny man, Mr. Comedian over there, talking about new beginnings. New beginnings is like forgiveness. I got to say, I am proud of my son, pointing at the bridal party. I am proud of my son, because he married that girl, and he forgave her. Talk about the bride. He forgave her, and he forgave me, because he knew that I was sleeping with her, and he forgave us. And I'm like, oh, my God. He forgave us. And then one of the groomsmen ran up to the dude and tried to take the mic. And he was like, nah, get back up, Thomas. Back up. Cause you not a man. You never did tell my son that you were screwing his wife, his woman too. You never gave him a chance to forgive you. And you and his brother Michael and his cousin Frank over there, all of y'all know she ran train. She let us run train for a 10-cent bag, and he ain't got the chance to forgive you. And I'm like, oh, my God. And while all of this is going on, they're trying to shut this dude up. And the father of the bride comes up to me and like, you need to fix this. And I'm like, what? So I'm like, excuse me, can I have your attention? Excuse me. They hushing little Flavor Flav out. Can I have your attention? Now, everybody's looking at me again. And, you know, people sitting there freaking out because of what just happened. And I'm like, oh, my God, I don't know what to do. So all I could think to do was, I am very proud of the groom for forgiving the bride. And that is the beginning. And good luck. And then I just walked out. I left. Now, if the father of the bride is listening to this, I would appreciate if you mailed me my check. But if you don't mail me my check, I understand, because I can get a lot of mileage out of this story on stage. So y'all like this and share, and peace out.